Normally it takes us about a week to build the wash plant pad, and we started yesterday. Well, the pressure's on. And now we're at the point where we can get this. Holy, this thing has some gremlins in it. My other hose down because it's doing a parked regen. This one's on the fritz. ECU failure, communications failure. Now it won't move. And now it just died. Yeah, she. Come on, Jerv. Let's go.
It's a massive blow. Without the powerful 700 excavator, finishing the 60-foot-high megapad could take days. The shutdown has already cost Tyson 5 hours.
Absolute mess on top of the batteries here.
How's it going, Tay? Want me to get Dumit's canoe for you?
Yeah, we might need it.
Is there any chances of it running tonight, Tay?
No way.
No?
No way. You have to probably use one of the other hose.
Okay.
With the 700 out of action, Tyson is forced to finish the pad using the smaller 480.
Yeah, you know, normally we use the 750 or the 700, which is a lot bigger than a 480, but I guess I gotta make do with the 480. You know, with Slucifer coming to an end in the bad cut, it's my responsibility to get this pad set up.
At the ugly cut, plant boss Tyson Lee's operation has been down for 24 hours as he builds an ambitious new pad.
Well, there goes the last rock truckload of grizzly tailings. The plant pad is done. We can drag Slucifer over here and start on the ugly.
Tyson's banking on the elevated pad to accelerate his production rate. But first he must move Slucifer up the steepest ramp he's ever built.
Right now we're just hooking up the cables, and we're gonna drag Slucifer over to the wash plant pad we built. It's looking pretty good over there. Just gotta get her up there safely. The 700 was having issues, and Alec figures it's electrical, so we're gonna have to make it work with the 480. You know, this is kind of like trying to move a dump truck with a two-door sedan. This is why it would be nice to have the 700 to move this thing, because right now I'm struggling to pull it, and 700 would just move it like none other. But I think where we're gonna really struggle is gonna be pulling it up the pad and getting it turned.
It'll be interesting to see how Tyson gets the plant up here and swings it around. He'll definitely be on the sides of it, and that's a dirt slump, so that's about as steep as it's gonna get.
Well, it's gonna be a foot at a time.
You know, as you can tell, the 480 is really struggling to pull this thing up. Just gotta get her to the top of this hill and spin it a little. This 480 is not liking this kind of abuse.
I wonder how much he trusts those cables. Because if he's loaded up like that and they pop, the excavator could even just go upside down right over.
Yeah. Yeah, that's quite a drop there.
Please don't come at me, wash plant.
Almost at the bottom. Looks all good.
So right now we're just trying to spin this Lucifer and make sure it ends lined up with the trough I've made, because if it doesn't, it's going to be a fight trying to move it side to side.
Oh, perfect. Thank you.
Well, guys, she's in place.
Yeah.
But good work, guys.
Good work in the excavator. That's some professional level stuff right there.
That heel on that side, that was impressive.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
Let's get back at her.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Slucifer's now ready to start running hundreds of yards of gold-rich pay dirt.
You know, we got Slucifer in place, level, banks in place. As you can tell, there's a lot of drop for fine tailings to go, and yeah, it's definitely high up there. Here we go. Here starts the ugly cut.
That was the first scoop right there.
But you've been busy this week. You got Slucifer moved over to the new wash plant pad. She's tall.
Yeah, man, it's up there. It was difficult getting it in place. It's nice to see it up there, and hopefully don't have to mess with tailings too much.
That should be one solid wash plant pad.
Oh, yeah, man, it was nuts. I'm looking forward to the cleanup here, Dumit.
Hopefully there's some gold in it.
Well, you want to see what we got?
Time to find out if the last of the bad cut lived up to its name.
Take your guess, Parker.
What do you got?
192. Based on how he's holding it.
10, 20, 40, 60, 130, 160.
It's over.
200.
Ah,
it's 220, 240, 250, 277.05.
I was way off.
Worth just under $500,000.
That's a good cleanup.
Yeah, no kidding. It's your last of the bad cut, so now we gotta see what the ugly cut's gonna do, right?
Yeah, hopefully not hold up to its name.
All right, just the first of Big Red.
Parker spent over $4 million getting down to pay in Mud Mountain after drill results showed it was four times richer than any other Indian River ground.
I see you got two pans, Dumit, so what are you trying to tell me?
My scale goes up to 400 ounces. With the way Mud Mountain has been going, right here, you guys, is 400 ounces.
Well, that's a good way to start.
That's the first thermos.
400 on the dot.
This is plus the 400.
Let's see what we got on top of 400.
20, 40, 100, 130, 180. 196.6.
For a total of 596.6 ounces in
That's
one week.
That's incredible.
Wow.
Worth over $1 million.
We've been busy down here, let's put it that
buddy.
Way.
I mean, just last week, Big Red had its best week and it just topped it.
This is the best week of Red's history from day one.
It's just wild how much effort and stripping went into it and how fast you're getting through it. Every hour of sluicing probably represents $1,000 worth of stripping or something, right? Or $2,000 worth of stripping.
For the week, you guys, believe it or not, it's 873.65 ounces. Jeez.
Worth over $1.5 million. Parker's biggest gold weigh of the season.
I never thought after last week we'd top what we just did, but it's a matter of if it'll hold out for long enough to make it worthwhile.
Let's do this again next week.
Yeah, let's do it again a few more times.
Okay. A few more times, yep.
Okay. We'll try.
Yep. Good job, guys, all three of you. Hell of a week.
Yeah. So how many rounds of golf did you miss?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I didn't know I was gonna have to work every day.